name is Eduardo Montoya, and I'm a science and mathematics teacher at West Chicago Community High School. I spent 8 weeks of the 2016 summer working and learning at Fermilab as a participant in the TRAC program for school science teachers. These 8 weeks at Fermilab was an amazing experience of learning and work. 320 hours at Fermilab covered a wide variety of experiences, if I can categorize them in a quantitative way according to time and activity participation. This could be the breakdown: 13 hours attending lectures, the undergraduate lecture series, 12 hours attending the 2016 user meetings presentations, 8 hours approximately touring the Fermi facilities, 60 hours approximately of reading and studying on particle physics and related fields, and 194 hours approximately of work for Dr. Ramad Ramad with the HFG flash computer simulation. Also 16 hours or workshop with the high school teachers on science promoted by the Wabansi Community College, 8 hours of meetings and lectures with the TRAC teachers. I will comment on these activities in more detail later, but now I would like to tell what Fermilab is and what is done here. Fermilab is the America's premier laboratory for particle physics and accelerator research, and it is funded by the United States Department of Energy. Thousands of scientists from universities and laboratories around the world collaborate at Fermilab on experiments at the frontiers of discovery. Particle physics studies the subatomic world, a world beyond the electron, proton, and neutrons, and encompasses smaller particles like quarks, photons, neutrinos, and muons, as well as a wide range of exotic particles. Particle physicists aim to discover what the universe is made of and how it works. The current scope of the subatomic particles has been classified into what is known as the Standard Model. It describes the fundamental interaction, strong, weak, and electromagnetic forces, and how Gauss bosons mediate in those forces. The mentioned Gauss bosons are the gluons W minus, W plus, and Z bosons, and the photons. The Standard Model contains 24 fundamental particles, 12 particles, and their associated antiparticles, which are the constituents of all matter. In order to confirm theories at this level, scientists and engineers in Fermilab had partnered together to produce the most complex and advanced machines that our mind can conceive. The result of that partnership, which you can see in abundance here at Fermilab, is the huge expansion in humankind's understanding of matter, energy, space, and time. Fermilab campus is 6,800 acres of terrain located in Batavia, Illinois. Spread around the campus, with the Wilson Building as the center of activities, there are several laboratories housing different experiments related to elemental particles, dark matter, dark energy, cosmic radiation, etc. The following is a retell of my visit to some of those locations. The accelerator source and control room. It is the area where negatively charged hydrogen ions from the new radio frequency quadrupole, RFQ, are accelerated through the linear accelerator, called the LINAC, to energy of 400 mega electrovolts. The LINAC consists of two main sections, and low-energy drift tube LINAC and the high-energy side coupled cavity LINAC. The industrial area, SRF and magnets. In the industrial area, Fermilab's technical division designs and builds state-of-the-art superconducting radio frequency (SRF) accelerating systems and superconducting magnets, among other things. D0 antivatron. D0 is one of the two detectors of Fermilab where the proton-antiproton collisions took place in the antivatron. It is a ring of almost 4 miles of circumference that was the largest accelerator until the start-up of the Large Hadron Collider in CERN in Europe. The Silicon Detector Facility, or CDET. The 500 megapixel dark energy camera that is now mounted in the telescope in Chile was built in the CDET facility. Currently, the CDET facility contains clean rooms and laboratories for assembly and testing of detectors for both high energy physics and astrophysics experiments. NUMI Underground, Minos, Minerva, and Nova experiments. We had to travel 300 feet underground in an elevator to be able to see the NUMI tunnel and check out the Minerva, Nova, and Minos near detectors. We learned about neutrino beams and long baseline experiments. The FAST experiment. We had the chance to check out the latest advances in superconducting radio frequency cavities that will be used to conduct the next generation of linear accelerators at the New Moon Lab, NML building. The undergraduate lecture series was a source of abundant and rich knowledge about all sorts of topics related to the science and technology experience in Fermilab. Attending these lectures and others was, for me, the presential component of a kind of intensive summer course in modern physics. I will mention some of them and their presenters. Introduction to Fermilab by its director, Nigel Logier. Accelerator Physics by Eric Priebus. Particle Physics by Harrison Prosper. The Science of Particle Detectors by Eric Rambert. Mechanical Engineer of Accelerators by Linda Valerio. Particle Physics at CMS by Don Lincoln. The Engineering of Particle Detectors by Gustavo Ganzello. Cancer Treatment with Particle Beams by Mark Pankoch. Scientific Computing at Fermilab by Eric Snyder. Dark Matter by Hook Lippincott. Measuring Proton Structures, Sequest by Brian Ransom. Piecing Together the History of the Universe by Brittany Kamai. Warp Space and Gravitational Lensing by Brian North. From the annual user meetings, there was 12 hours with 24 mini lectures by graduate and postdoctoral students. The today's participation of taking research into the classroom workshop for high school teachers at Wabansee Community College gave us a practical and hands-on experience in how to integrate the research on particle physics into our classrooms. I enjoyed the meetings with the TRAC group, the sharing with the colleagues from other parts of the country, and the lecture coordinated by Dr. Chung and Dr. Jindal. Finally, my work at Fermilab was in the area of computing simulation of experiment and data collection and basic analysis. I work under the mentorship of Dr. Ramad Ramad. He is a physicist who developed a computer simulation called HFG-Flash, a very fast simulation of electromagnetic showers using parameterizations of the profiles in the hadronic forward calorimeter. His current goal is to increase the simulation calculation speed and improve accuracy even further. My assignment consisted in running the program, changing alternatively the parameters for energy at the time of the impact and values for the angles phi and eta of the particles. Phi is the measurement of the azimuthal angle, or angle from the x-axis. Eta, or pseudo-rapidity, is a special graphical coordinate describing the angle of a particle in relation to the particle beam, or z-axis. This simulation calculates the statistical mean and the RMS, the root mean squared deviation of energy for 10,000 events for short fiber, long fiber, and a combination of both in the detector of the calorimeter. The simulation was done for electrons and pions, changing the same three parameters mentioned before. The results were tallied and entered in Excel. Regression lines were constructed from the data, mostly showing a linear correlation between initial energy of the particles and the energy mean detected in the calorimeter. These computer experiences posed me to the Python and Root programs, which are of common use in Fermilab and by the global scientific community. As I close this document, I must say that this experience had a very positive effect in me as a science lover and perhaps low-level science practitioner. It has been a renewal of hope for the future of the world when I see the number of students involved in different programs and at different levels in science and technology in Fermilab. I am committing myself in becoming a promoter of what Fermilab has to offer for students and teachers. I will bring in testimony to my classmates and colleagues in my school of what this experience means to me and how they can benefit of this too. My gratitude to Harry Chung, Ramad Ramad, Pratima Jamal, and all those who in one way or another made this participation possible. Also, I give my salute and thanks to my fellow TRAC teachers for your camaraderie and kindness. Thank you.